Heya Tech Archie Gang, I'm now breaking down the Suicide Squad teaser trailer. A few years ago, some tweets from Gang's gun reappeared and this led him fired from the production of Gun Galaxy Volume 3. Who knows how that's gonna work now. And basically the whole of the MCU. And there was a Patreon campaign thing to like bring him back, but now he's moved to DC, which means this film is going to be way more better, and he can take his skills to this. Yeah, and Disney are strict, and there's not very, they restrict a lot of things, so one of others is perfect. So it's got a totally different feel, and the music is amazing, I'm guessing. Well, who knows when the film's gonna come out? 2021. I keep my eyes open for that. Speaking of which, Yondu, Michael Rooker, who played Yondu in the Guardians of the Galaxy films, is now in the DC as...
Where is he?
I'm getting a Kick-Ass-like kind of vibe. It's a lot more comic booky, and like, it's not so serious now, I don't think. Harley Quinn has a completely different look. She doesn't have like the big hammer like she did in Birds of Prey, and in the comics, she now has a massive gun. Well, it's not actually that massive, but yeah. She now has a massive gun. Well, it's not that massive, but it's pretty big. Like a rifle or machine gun. And her outfit has completely changed again. It's all red, it's like Scarlet Witch. The gun can turn into a rocket launcher. Also a recurring star. What did I just say? So, Heimdall, yeah, that character in the MCU, he died in Infinity War. And now, Idris Elba, he's Luther, he's moved to DC. Actually, he had coronavirus, so... Good thing. He's a very good actor. He's in Hobbs and Shaw. He's a machine gun. He has loads of machine guns. Am I surprised? One thing I can say, I don't know how to bring Sharkman, or whatever the name is, to the big screen and make it serious. Make it work. His name is King Shark. What I'm most excited for is Peter Capaldi, who portrayed the 12th Doctor. He's now in DC. I've known this for quite a while. He's now playing a villain called The Thinker. But is he going to be swearing 24/7?
Hey, people, listen up. It's a fucking lockdown right now.
Come off it. We're not in a prison drama, are we?
We are in a prison drama. This is the fucking Shawshank Redemption, right? But with more tunneling through shit, no fucking redemption. Right, people, nobody move, right? Nobody move. Nobody gets fucking truncheoned in the face. This is a lockdown, right? What that means is, this office is now an isolation unit. Do not use the phones. No fucking emails. No phones, Glenn. Come on.
I got to go. Bye.
Sean Gunn, James Gunn's brother, he played Cadillac in the Gun Galaxy film. He did survive. I'm not sure what his future lies in the MCU now. Especially with Corona, Infinity War, and what, James Gunn Twitter. Yeah, he's playing like a Squirrel White rat like kind of character. It matches. He do a really good job. Wait a minute, Jay Courtney, didn't he die in Birds of Prey because he was in that film? Or was he totally different then?
John Cena!
Are you sure about that?
He looks like Ant-Man. The logo and feel has totally Hey, it's Coach again. Here's my trailer breakdown of the teaser trailer for Black Adam.
I've been waiting for this moment for a very long time. This is the one. This is the one that's going to change everything. This is Black Adam. Five 5,000 years ago, Kandak was a melting pot of cultures, wealth, power, and magic. Yet most of us had nothing, except for the chains around our necks. Kandak needed a hero. Instead, they got me. I did what needed to be done, and they imprisoned me for it. Now, 5,000 years later, I'm free. And I give you my word. No one will ever stop me again.
The first shot is in like a cave kind of thing. So, Black Adam, from this trailer, we can tell he's totally different from the other DC superheroes. He's a god, and he had to fight someone, which meant he got imprisoned, and he was created for a reason, and now he is free. This will be an interesting kind of film, and we've got Dwayne Johnson playing him. What else can we not want? What else can people nitpick about it? Heya Tech Archie Gang, I am breaking down the Batman teaser trailer.
You're becoming quite a celebrity. Why is he writing to you?
If you are justice, please do not lie. What is the price for your blind eye?
The hell are you supposed to be?
I'm vengeance.
Whoa! This guy's crazy!
I like the red logos and that sound of duct tape, but we see what that is in a minute. Someone's killed someone and then put duct tape all over their face and written in red or blood, no more lies. So one of the villains is the Riddler, which we need to see a new Riddler that's done properly, because the only live action Riddler we have seen is Jim Carrey in Batman Forever, and that film, oh no. There's a lot of assassinations and terrorists going on. Like, that happens all the time in superhero films, to be honest. Sorry guys if I offended anyone with that. Ooh, Catwoman.
The hell are you supposed to be?
This bit is epic when he beats up some Joker-like thugs.
I'm vengeance.
And Batman, with his head down in the rain, is so epic. And now the Batmobile! Ho ho! And then it's like, you know the scene, there's a scene in Batman Begins when he finally gets to the Scarecrow. There's a scene like that in this film, trailer, whatever. And that logo and the transformation. I think it's been delayed to 2022 now. And Rob Pattinson, or whatever, had COVID-19. Yeah, if you're a Batman fan, I also was a part of a project in which we had to recreate the Dark Knight interrogation scene, and I played Batman. We were Michael Myers mask. It was tight on budget. It's here right now.
You're one of me. Here I am.
I want to see what you'd do. And you didn't disappoint. You let 5 people die, and then you let Dent take your place. Even for a guy like me, that's cold.
Where's Dent?
Those muffles when you're gone. So they can go back to the way things used to be. But I know the truth. There's no going back. You've changed things. Forever.
Then why do you want to kill me?
Kill you? I don't want to kill you.
What'd I do without you? Go back to ripping off mob
dealers? No. No, no. You. You complete me.
Your garbage are kills for money.
Don't talk like one of them. You're not one of them, even if you'd like to be. To them, you're just a freak.
Like me. They need you now. But when they don't, they'll cast you out like a leper. You see, their morals, their code is just a bad joke. Dropped at the first sign of trouble. They're only as good as the world allows them to be. I'll show you. But these civilized people, they'll eat each other.
It's also elsewhere as a separate video, so yeah. Hey, to Cut Your Gun, here's my trailer breakdown of the No Time to Die trailer, number 2.
The past isn't dead.
Fate draws us back together. Now your enemy is my enemy.
His name is Safin.
And what does he want?
Revenge. Me.
When her secret finds its way out, it'll be the death of you.
You can imagine why I've come back to play.
There's a young lady in Santiago I want you to meet.
You're late.
When you're ready. Salute.
I met your new 00.
She's a disarming young woman.
I get why you shot him.
Yeah, well, everyone tries at least once.
James Bond.
We both eradicate people to make the world a better place. I just want to be a little tidier.
Come on, Bond. Where the hell are you?
Do you ever fly one of these?
Nope.
Harder to tell the good from bad, villains from heroes these days.
What is it?
You don't know what this is.
He's going to kill millions.
If we don't do this, there will be nothing left to save.
Are
I saw the No Time to Die trailer twice in the cinemas before lockdown, in 1917 and Birds of Prey. I got a review of that. It was supposed to come out in April, but then Corona came. There's a car chase, and oh, by the way, before we get into James Bond, that music is epic in the Batman trailer, and there's also the Dark Knight trailer. Someone edited a Dark Knight trailer, but edited in the side Batman, and that trailer is epic. So anyway, let's talk about James Bond. So there's a car chase, and people are trying to shoot James Bond, so he's being hunted, and then he jumps off the bridge. That scene is epic. So Universal now own James Bond. Freddie Mercury! Explosions, blah blah blah. It's an action movie with James Bond, what do you expect? The car is upgraded with more guns, I think. I also like the music and logos in this, the film and the trailer.